It's a blessing and a privilege.
Something that I love unconditionally.
It's been my whole life.
My life.
And my family, my kids.
A lifetime.
A lifetime of passion, love, and fulfillment.
We've all been given the gift of basketball.
It started when I was a young kid that fell in love with this orange ball.
This gift is something more.
Opportunity.
Opportunity. Endless opportunity.
To be able to see the world.
Meeting wonderful people.
Friendships and bonds, the places it can take you.
Something that motivates us.
The gift of passion, something that's bigger than myself.
Inspires us.
Definitely give me a platform.
A platform to help and change lives.
And becomes us.
A program that I hoped and dreamed of.
The joy.
The thrill of victory and the agony of defeat.
The gift.
Higher education.
It's completely changed my life. In.
Leadership.
It brings to you.
The memories never go away.
To me and to us.
All of this, this little orange ball has created.
Man, I love this sport.
Basketball is awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Welcome to Reynolds Coliseum. It's the final game of the preseason WNIT, and we have two undefeated squads in this tournament. Offenses with the NC State Wolfpack rolling two straight wins. The Towson Tigers, 85 points a game in two victories. These are dynamic clubs ready to battle it out. And here we are courtside with Ernie Myers. I'm Evan Budrovich. And tonight with so much offensive firepower, how does the senior All-American Elisa Kinane get herself involved?
Well, they got to get her the ball first and foremost, but attacking the offensive and defensive glass and just being a terror on the offensive end.
Kinane's coming off a slow start to her season, just 10 points a game. Ernie, yesterday, a double-double in her performance against Florida. How has she gotten herself going?
Well, she on the offensive glass, and she's everybody's All-American. That game, she showed everybody that she's back in the game.
Kinane, the senior, always a player to watch. And for Towson, Aaliyah Nelson, the junior guard, 39 points against Florida to start this tournament. What a dynamic scoring presence.
Man, she's Russell Westbrook-type numbers. 23-8-8. She's been balling in this tournament.
Carla Fountain with our lead official to tip it off. And NC State in the alternate grays gets the basketball to begin things here in Reynolds. First matchup since 2013-14. And Kinane wastes no time with an easy layup.
And there she is. Got position and powered that up.
So Ernie, in those first two games, struggled offensively. How has she found her confidence in the last three nights?
They've just been giving her the ball. I just think they coaches has established her in the post, and they've been focused on getting her to rock.
Allie Kubek off on the three. She scored 25 yesterday in a win over Wofford, and a jump ball keeps possession here. That starting five averages 75 points. It's a starter-heavy lineup. Remember, top scoring threat, Rain Tucker, off the bench for Diane Richardson. Mm-hmm. She's out for the next 8 days, recovering from an ACL injury. That's a huge addition for Towson next week.
Oh, yes. When she comes back, they're going to have another offensive threat.
Nelson's been a big threat herself. 39 points on Friday. Comes up way short on the three. And Kayla Jones, nice bounce pass ahead to Crutchfield, who gets the foul, an and one.
Nice push by KJ, and that's the her ability to push the ball from the four spot. Nice bounce pass to Crutchfield for the nice lay-in.
Ty Crutchfield playing her 120th career game tonight. And the guard completes the three-point play. What an ideal start for NC State. 5-0 in a matchup of two teams that are undefeated in this tournament, both with dominant victories over Wofford and Florida. Nelson, not only the best scorer, the best assist maker in the Colonial this year. 8 assists a game, number 4 in the black, always a threat. And here she sits up top with a shot clock at 10.
Wolfpack is playing a tough man-to-man.
Nelson with 5, gets the switch on Perez, and floats it short. That was affected by the NC State defense. There's the presence of Kinane down low.
Yeah, when she saw Kinane stepping up, it affected her shot.
Kinane challenged by her coach, Wes Moore, to be more assertive on both ends of the ball. We've seen a layup early, and now an affected shot in the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, she's focused. She's locked in.
NC State needs the All-American to play at her best with the ACC Big Ten Challenge coming up in 2 weeks. As Kinane, with some contact, goes into Kubek, and that's an early foul on the Towson post presence.
Yeah, I don't think they got anybody down there that can guard Kinane in this game tonight.
Kubek, such a strong offensive presence, the sophomore from Elkton, Maryland, here with the foul.
Here's a nice pass in to Kinane. She wants that back. She said that should have been an and one.
Kunae made about everything she shot yesterday. 7 of 10 from the field in the win over Florida. And Ernie, in that 30-point victory for NC State, Wes Moore was about as happy as any coach in the country with his post-game comments.
Yes, and that's the happiest I've seen him after a game since I've been doing these games.
He also earned his 750th career win in that performance as a head coach.
That's a good reason to be happy as well. He's one of the top coaches in the game today.
Out to Nelson, who's been lights out to start this tournament. Anissa Rivera, the NC Central transfer, playing back in the Raleigh area, finds a shooter in Tariana Gary, and another air ball for Towson early in this game, Ernie. That's five shots, and three haven't even touched net.
Well, that's the defense that NC State is applying. They're applying the pressure on the perimeter.
So Reyna Perez walks it up the floor, the graduate senior leading this point. Only averaging 5 points in this tournament, but her assist making has picked up, really setting up her offense.
Yeah, she's one of the best point guards in the country.
On cue, Kunae on a great dime is blocked by Kubek. Good defense from Towson. They love to run. Diane Richardson in year five wants the pace and the flow of this offense to move very quickly.
Yeah, the Wolfpack gets back on defense very quickly. So they're going to have to get a majority of their points in the set offense.
Nice drive by Evans, who comes up short, getting the start in replace of the injured Rain Tucker, who will be back next Tuesday from an ACL injury. Kunae on the circle, bit short.
She's getting the position. She's just not finishing.
Nelson pops a free throw jumper. A nice start. Boy, if Aaliyah Nelson gets hot, what a dangerous score at 23 points a night.
Yeah, she looks good on that nice pull-up jumper right there from the free throw line.
They call her Bean around the program, and she is nothing but net in this tournament, shooting 70% as Kunae forced up a shot.
Kunae is rushing her shots tonight.
Nelson kicks to Rivera. She can pop from three-point range. Just rattles out. And a rebound for Ja'Kia Brown-Turner. NC State defeated Florida by 32 yesterday. Won the battle on the glass, plus 15. Such a huge factor for Wes Moore's club. Also in that game, 11 three-point makes. And we have a foul away from the ball. Three early fouls for Towson.
Kubek had a little hands-on on Kunae. Trying to push out of position.
Diane Richardson, interesting enough, she's a big hugger with her players, loves to embrace her players, and she said this trip has been so great to find the bond and camaraderie 4 days in Raleigh and a chance for her team not only to play well but really grow as a unit as Ja'Kia Brown-Turner makes the lay.
Nice pass, inbounds pass by Perez.
Ernie, as a former player here at NC State, what is the value of spending quality time with a team on a road and really building that camaraderie early in the season?
It means a whole lot. I mean, we won a national championship. All of our players, we hung out with each other. We loved each other, and that's what you need.
NC State loves this start as Gary saves it and able to throw it back to Nelson. Tariana Gary, guard, has been fantastic. Finds Rivera, and Towson, one of eight from the field.
Yeah, they're kind of rushing their shots. They're not getting the shots in their offense.
Pace and space are the key words for Diane Richardson here in year five, the former West Virginia associate head coach. And Jones is fouled underneath as an offensive foul, in fact. So a turnover for NC State.
KJ had position. I don't know. I didn't see that foul. I guess here we go. She's just running. She just has position.
That little arm bar possibly there?
Oh, yeah, a little hook, but.
That is a point of emphasis in women's college basketball this year, the offensive player initiating contact.
Yeah, but that wasn't an aggressive forearm move.
Speaking of aggressive, Rivera into the body of Jones and goes to the free throw line, where Rivera has been fantastic at the charity stripe, 75% as a forward for Towson.
Yeah, she can really stroke the free throws. She's a transfer from UNC. Defensive is a player of the year in the conference.
So Rivera, who was the MEAC Player of the Year this past spring. What a nice addition. Grew up at 10 years old, played for Diana in the AAU ball. That's how they found Rivera from NC Central. All of a sudden, 14 points a game and a nice third scorer behind Nelson.
Oh, yeah, and they call Richardson the queen of the DMV. And I'm not talking about the Department of Motor Vehicles. It's the Delaware, Maryland, Virginia area. They love her in that area. She's established in that area in recruiting. Everybody loves her in the DMV.
Ja'Kia Brown Turner with a great shot fake and sets up a three.
She has the best left-hand stroke in college basketball. That's her game.
She also was an All-American last season as Rivera comes up short. Nice offensive board for Ryan Evans. This Towson club only runs 7 to 8 players deep with 2 major injuries at the start of the year. Tucker's out for the next week. And Wilson recovering back, the true freshman, so some cogs returning for Towson. Nelson carries the load tonight and comes up strong. That's last touch by the Tigers.
See, they can.
So NC State leads by 8. We'll have more after this.
Welcoming this back from break. Yeah, attendance in the sellout for the season.
Goes on.
Yeah. Nelson is 1 for 4. They make it out.
Welcome back to Reynolds Coliseum here for the preseason women's NIT. NC State, the home team, leading Towson right now 12-4. Westmore's team playing its 4th home game here to start this season in just 7 days. It's a sellout this season for the Pac women's basketball team. But Westmore says that's nothing new for this program. He points even back to pre-pandemic times when he says this program sold out 3 of our last 4 basketball games to end that 2019-2020 season. He says the things that matter the most to us this season is making sure that we give this home crowd a W every time they're here.
Well, Marilyn, good evening. And certainly to her point, NC State, that home loss to South Carolina early in the year. Some nice adjustments the last 2 games as Ja'Kia Brown-Turner travels. What have they shown the fans the last 3 home games?
They showed them a lot. I mean, they've won these last 3, last 2 games, actually. And they've been getting up and down the court and giving the fans something to cheer about.
Westmore said there's no greater marketing of a program than winning basketball games, to Maryland's point. And here at home, they're averaging 85 points a night. That offense has clicked in the first quarter, led by 5 from Brown-Turner. Our first look at Sky Williams, the backup point guard. Checks in, the senior from Indianapolis. Nelson just 1 of 4 shooting today, marked up by Diamond Johnson.
Diamond Johnson's playing defense.
There's a steal for
Hitchens
Johnson.
On a push.
Johnson up ahead.
Nice pass.
And with contact, Madison Hayes goes to the free throw line. All starts with the defense, though, Ernie.
Yeah, that's what's going to win this game today, defense. And Diamond Johnson on the push.
Fourth team foul for Towson early in this game. Remember, not a team very deep in the bench. Sort of a diamond in the rough for this program is Diamond Johnson, the transfer from Rutgers. Starting to find her camaraderie and her rhythm with this club.
Yeah, I mean, she's really is a blessing in practice. They love her. She's one of the top point guards in the country. And she's coming off the bench.
All she did was finish second team all Big Ten in the spring, join a new club as one of three transfers.
She's on the watch list, her and Perez.
One of five players for NC State on the national watch list. It's a talented team, but certainly to Wes's point, they have to perform well too. Can't just be about the numbers. As Rivera finishes strong on the floater, Towson now one of 11 shooting.
And that's Madison Hayes. She plays hard.
Ooh, Johnson, great floater.
She's a great scorer.
How dynamic of a team does Wes Moore have when Johnson's the best guard off the bench here in the second first quarter?
And she's one of the best point guards in the country. So when you can have her come in for Perez, you're not losing too much.
Rivera comes up strong on the three. She played in this building last year for NC Central, had 16 points. However, Towson looking for major points, down 16-4 in the first. Johnson, great crossover, gets to her spot and misses the teardrop. Her own rebound.
She's got that Philly herky-jerky game.
Crutchfield, there you go.
Crutchfield with the three.
Timeout Towson, NC State, 11 three-pointers the last two nights. They hit their first two here. Wolfpack lead by 15. A 10-0 run for NC State, capped off by the three-pointer from Crutchfield.
Here's Crutchfield, nice dish to Kai. She was hot yesterday. She had 4 three-pointers in yesterday's game against Florida.
Crutchfield, knock on wood here, 8 of her last 8 from the field. So efficient as Williams floats up a beauty, comes up short. Nice rebound, and with the foul, that's Nari Dodson checking in, the senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Size is affecting Towson in this game right now.
Nari Dodson, the transfer from Bossier Parish Community College. This is her first year. And Camille Hobby, speaking of new players to the program, the junior checks in. Kunane, a quick breather in this first quarter. Very efficient opening frame for Kunane. 4 points, couple of blocks. This is where Towson has dominated in the last two games at the free throw line. In fact, in the first two games of this tournament, Towson's been to the line 47 times.
That's a lot.
Including 25 made free throws against Florida.
Well, you won't see them at the free throw line like in a lot this game. State doesn't foul a lot. They play a lot of position defense.
That defense has held Towson to 1 of 13 shooting. Meanwhile, offensively, the Wolfpack are 6 of 10. Crutchfield around the pick, and an illegal screen on Hobby. Nicely drawn by Sky Williams.
Yeah, Hobby kind of stuck her leg out on that play.
Yeah, you're being generous. She threw the hip there a little bit.
Yeah, she gave it a little hip check on the screen.
Alongside former NC State national champion Ernie Myers, Evan Budgerbich with you tonight from Raleigh. This is the final game of the opening weekend of the women's NIT. NC State will face Kansas State next Friday in this building. This upcoming Friday. The weeks all blend together early. Johnson gets the rebound. Ooh, keeps it herself and goes to the free throw line, but she traveled.
She was on the move in that play. Here she goes right here. Diamond on the push.
One, two, with the fake. Three. Oop, yep, there's your third step. Love the creativity.
She wish she could have that one back.
From Diamond Johnson.
She's a Philly product, and they have a city game. She was the first woman to play in the Allen Iverson All-Star game.
Towson needs to find some offense. One of 14 shooting. So Gary comes up out on the three. Towson 0 of 8 from downtown. They enter this game hitting 9 threes a contest.
Well, these threes are being contested in this game.
Brown Turner, high ball dribble, finds Hayes. NC State, 4 assists on 6 made baskets. Johnson says, who needs the pass when I can hit the three?
And that's her shot. She's a three-point shooter. She shot 40% from three-point range last year at Rutgers.
Make it look easy from downtown. Johnson 5 points off the bench. And Nelson still looking to get on the scoreboard. She comes up a bit limp on that right ankle. NC State in transition. Good kick out to Crutchfield. And a miss from three-point land. Waiting for the officials to blow this dead with Nelson.
Nelson, she's
slow to get up, holding that right knee. Athletic trainer Aaron Thomas taking a look. This is the last thing you want to see with a talented player, Aaliyah Nelson, going down here in this first quarter.
Yeah, she looked like she's in a lot of pain.
Towson team that has played 10 tonight, 10 different players. That's the most they've done in any game this season. Now might be without their top scorer, Aaliyah Nelson, at least for the rest of this quarter, if not
the rest of the game. I'm hoping she's able to get up and shake it off.
What adjustments can Diane Richardson and Zach Cantor and the staff accomplish as this game moves forward? Because clearly NC State's defense has been up to the challenge.
No, absolutely. And that's what Coach Moore preaches in practice, position defense without fouling. He can stop one player, definitely, in a game. So the supporting cast going to have to step up.
So if you are that supporting cast at Towson, outside of Nelson, just 1 of 5 shooting, we got to find some production, and we'll check out this injury here for Nelson, who continues to be treated by the training staff.
Here it is right here on the nice drive. She came down on Diamond's foot and twisted her knee. She can't put any pressure on that. It doesn't look good at all.
Diane Richardson, when speaking about Aaliyah, said she didn't know she had that many points in her, but what a leader she's developed into this year. And that's the last thing you want to see is an injury to a star player.
Yeah, I'm hoping that it's nothing serious.
It's a big test for Towson, already down 17 and without their best player for at least this quarter, if not more. So now it shifts onto the shoulders of Sky Williams, the new point guard in. Williams had a good cutter, and Dodson sticks it up to Rivera, who cannot knock down the three.
Yeah, she's continuing to take it.
So a foul the other way, and Ernie, you couldn't see it on a game cam, but the entire Towson staff clapping for Rivera, wanting her to take that shot. Mm-hmm. Even though it's not going down, they have confidence in the NC Central transfer.
Yeah, I mean, she's a great player, but sometimes when the shot's not falling, you got to go to the basket, get to the free throw line to get your game going. You know, get fouled, get to the free throw line, and maybe, you know, your shot will come back.
Here's Reyna Perez at the line for two. Makes the first. Here's Saturday's college football lineup on ACC Network and the ESPN app. A new Eastern coming off their exciting win against in-state rival Miami. Florida State takes on Phil Dracovich in bowl-eligible Boston College. And NC State looks to bounce back after a tough loss to Wake when they host Syracuse, who's looking to get bowl-eligible with a win. The day is capped off by two more teams looking to make the bowl games, Virginia Tech and Miami, both at 5-5. Busy day for college football on Saturday. Madison Hayes putting on her post moves. Ooh, that's pretty with a fadeaway, and Rivera gets her hand on it.
Yeah, Rivera played great defense.
And then Johnson says, I'm taking that right back with a baseball pass to Rivera.
Oh.
Oh, and Rivera goes into the band. Watch out.
Rivera plays hard.
That'll stay here for NC State. How about the effort from Anissa Rivera?
Yeah, she got back on that. Almost saved it inbound.
Speaking of football, Ernie Myers, Anissa Rivera not afraid of some contact.
Nah, she's going all out.
Follows that pulling guard through the hole. Yeah, makes
she,
a hit.
She looked like a corner on that.
So the Wolfpack can hold for the final shot. It's a 15-1 run to end this first quarter. NC State searching for a third straight win and a perfect start to WNIT. Johnson pops the jumper, and the hot start continues.
Johnson is shining bright.
Towson lost track of the clock, so that ends the first quarter. Diamond Johnson off the bench with 7 early points, and the Wolfpack storm out to a hot start. 17-1 run to end the opening frame. So the scoring pressure mounts to sophomore Allie Kubek. Scored 25 in her last game, the Delaware Gatorade Player of the Year. How does she carry the load here tonight?
Well, she has to get the ball because she's an inside player, so the guards have to get her the ball.
Towson's had distribution, but no shot making in that first quarter. NC State, no problem. A 17-1 run to end the first, and Hobby continues that stretch.
Hobby is a low post ball player, nice drop step, jump hook.
Ernie, we saw on Friday night against Wofford for NC State a slow start shooting the basketball. Well, here in this game, at 60%, how have they come out so electric on this Monday night?
Well, they're just getting shots in the right position. They're not forcing any shots. They're getting a lot of shots on the break. Diamond is pulling up from everywhere, knocking shots down.
Big smile there from Madison Hayes, the Mississippi State transfer. Here's where the impact players for NC State start to flex their muscle in this second quarter.
And they're taking what the defense is giving them. They're not rushing anything. All the shots that they're taking are in the floor of the offense.
For Hayes, Wolfpack have forced 4 turnovers in the first frame. Brown Turner on the attack. Look at that position for Hobby. And in the lobby, she drops it in.
Hobby. That's her game right there. She has great footwork. Nice turnaround jump shot by Hobby.
Scored 6 points against Florida yesterday, and a good jumper to get her night going. Quebec, haven't seen much of her offensively, just one shot. Tough floater for Williams, and the Towson shooting woes at 1 of 19.
All the shots that they're taking are contested.
Meanwhile, easy shots for NC State. That's Jakia Brown-Turner.
Nice look by Diamond. No look pass.
So Diamond Johnson, a measly 7 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. And we're 12 minutes into this game.
Diamond is shining bright in the arena tonight.
There's Johnson trying to save the basketball, but it goes out of play. Great work by our camera operator down there. She was moving and grooving to get out of the way. Excellent work.
Great Philly ball player. There's another great Philly.
We'll take a timeout here. NC State rolling early in the second quarter.
What'd you say?
Two minutes back.
Right here? I gotta wait. I mean, you want me further on the... Okay. All right. This is audio only then? Okay. Birthdays today. Thanks for joining us. Happy
back to Raleigh. For more on Diamond Johnson, we say hi to Marilyn Payne.
Well, Diamond Johnson co-leading NC State with 7 points, the 3 rebounds, and a beautiful no-look assist to this point. The sophomore transfer from Rutgers is a player that Westmore says he continues to hope will work in and stay comfortable with the Wolfpack. He didn't like her game versus South Carolina, but scoring 10 and 9 in the 2 games coming into this.
Certainly her presence, Ernie, in this game has been huge. 7 points off the bench. Wes Moore mentioning, to Maryland's point, trying to find her cohesiveness with this roster. It seems tonight she's found her perfect role.
Yeah. Coming off the bench, it's tough for a player like her when she starred at the previous school at Rutgers, averaging 17 points. But she's coming. She came here to be on the big stage. So, you know, you got to be a part of a team. And it's a lot of great players on this team, so she's going to have to find a way to fit in.
That was the first three of the night for Towson. Anissa Rivera heats up. She was 0 for 6 to start this game. Johnson on cue for three. Oop, bit off. one of the rare times she hasn't looked locked in this first half.
Yeah.
Gary with a long three. Towson really struggling from deep, but an offensive rebound scooped up by Quinzaya Fulmore and almost has a
Diamond
second.
On the rebound.
Look at Diamond shining bright among the six-footers.
Yeah, 5-5, and she's in there getting the rebound and pushing it.
Reyna Perez looking to operate. I've not called her name much tonight. Only one shot. Look at Johnson. This is, ooh, look at this.
Yes.
Look at that. There it is.
Head fakes, ball fakes. That's that Philly game. That's that Philly street game right there. Head and shoulder fakes. Nice pull-up jumper.
Had her defender, Sky Williams, on skates. Nearly double figures in this first half alone for Johnson. Sitting with nine and called for the hand touch foul. Wes Moore not a happy camper.
Here's Diamond Johnson with the head and shoulder fake. Head and shoulder fake. Here you go. Step back. Bang.
So, Ernie, that's putting the defender on the strings, right, on skates?
Yeah, she had her rope rocking and rolling.
Diamond Johnson, only a sophomore, scored 17 points a game last year. If she becomes the sixth man, seventh option for NC State, how does that make Westmore's team even better?
I mean, they got so many players that can come in. You haven't seen Genesis Bryant and Timmons. There's so many ball players on this ball club, but she's doing her thing today.
And don't forget about
an integral part of the team.
Don't forget about Reyna Perez with the steal.
Reyna Perez is a pro.
NC State has forced six turnovers, leading to an and one for guess who?
This is Diamond's breakout game, it looks like.
Double figures for Johnson and no answers for Towson's defense.
Here she goes on a shake and bake crossover. You can't guard me. There she goes.
Well, with that free throw,
she's a 90% free throw shooter.
NC State's season high for Johnson. We'll say that number a bunch throughout the season. New season highs for the first year transfer.
Yeah, she's a tough Philly ball player. We had one back in the day. Her number's up in the rafters. Linda Hawkeye Whitney, Hawkeye Page.
Where do you get the nickname Hawkeye from?
She should shoot the ball. She can shoot the ball like nobody you ever seen.
Main, good floater. A bit strong. Johnson almost had the rebound there.
Yeah, she scored 100 points in a high school game and was.
So the Wilt Chamberlain factor.
Oh, yeah, she did. Linda Page, rest in peace.
Her number sits in the rafters here at PNC, at Reynolds Coliseum. Of course, your number sits at PNC Arena across the street. There's a long three, and Dodson not even close off the backboard. NC State leaning on its bench tonight, 20 bench points. Kunane, the All-American, goes to work.
Yeah, they have nobody down there that can stop her.
We mentioned in the opener, Ernie, the importance of offense and scoring the basketball. However, for Towson, just 2 of 25 shooting. Free throws now for Ryan Evans. How do the Tigers find some chemistry offensively without Aaliyah Nelson?
It's going to be very hard. I mean, in the size of the NC State ball players and the way they play defense and contest shots, it's going to be hard for them to get back in this game.
Remember, Towson, the first two nights of this tournament, 90 points against Wofford, 85 points against Florida, and for Diane Richardson, she's without her top scorer, Leah Nelson, and clearly without an ideal start in this first half.
No, and they're playing against the number five team in the country at home with a crowd here. It was going to be difficult anyway, but without Nelson, it's going to be extremely hard for them to get back into this game. They're down 32 points, and it's 5 minutes to go in the second quarter.
This is the best start for Towson since 2016, and here's Mariah Wilson, the true freshman, getting her first minutes of the season out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Reyna Perez has played a few more games than that. The fifth-year senior brings it up the court. Nice steal by Wilson, and her debut goes coast-to-coast for the layup.
Great steal. Now she's bringing some energy to the game.
Okay, keep the freshman in more. Mariah Wilson, who's her all-time leading high school scorer, 1,830 points at Lancaster Mennonite. Diane Richardson pulling an ace out of her cards. Kunane, she's a well-known commodity and banks it in.
She's hard to guard down there. They don't have anybody down there that can guard the All-American.
And this is Rivera tried it and collected her second foul. What a mismatch Kunane's been tonight.
Here she is right here with the nice drop step and the and one. Alisa Kunane.
Here's Allie Kubek, the All-CAA rookie team member last year. She has big shoes to fill with the injuries to Rain Tucker in the preseason and Aaliyah Nelson tonight. Meanwhile, for Kunane, just crossed 1,400 career points yesterday. Rain Tucker, top scorer for Towson last year, out with an ACL injury. She returns next Tuesday, so plenty of bright spots for the Tigers coming up next week.
Yeah, but they still going to need Aaliyah moving forward.
No, you're right.
I hope she's, you know.
Aaliyah Nelson injured her knee midway through the first quarter.
I hope nothing serious.
Was helped off the court by her trainer. Great ball movement here to Johnson, who took an extra step. I feel like great players just can get away with an extra traveling step, but not tonight with Carla Fontaine on the call.
No. She's quick with that. She has a quick first step. And maybe the ref got to get used to that. I didn't see the walk there.
That might be the one thing Wes Moore has thoughts on after this game. 7 turnovers in the first half for NC State.
Yeah.
There has to be something to keep an eye on as Sky Williams hits the jumper. Towson finally shooting better in this game, 25% in this quarter, after making just 2 shots in the first. Kunane on Kubek, no foul, and a basket. Double figures now for Kunane.
There's the big smile.
11 points for Alisa. She's moved into 19th in NC State all-time scoring. Has a chance to catch up to Jania Beasley. She would need about 25 points a game to get there, but it is possible if the season stretched out into postseason play and you name it.
Yeah. With all this talent on the team, I don't think she's going to average 25 points a game.
Kubek comes up strong, and now the Wolfpack in transition. Perez finds a shooter. This is Timmons for 3 now.
Timmons.
Williams recovers.
She's the all-time leading scorer, female basketball player in the history of the state of North Carolina.
And this is Rivera. The struggles continue. She does draw a foul this time. And after a 1-for-8 start, got bumped by Kunane. Rivera's such a scrappy, physical player. It's been tough to see her struggle from the field.
Yeah, she's a decent defensive player. You know, she plays hard. She gives it all she has. I hope she's okay, because if she's out, there's no way they're getting back in this game. Here she is right here going hard to the basket. Missed the shot. Here she is on the follow.
Okay, she got the elbow to the face.
Yeah, she got elbowed in the head by Kunane.
And this is Rivera in 15 games last year for NC Central. Had 9 double-doubles. Huh. Just incredible numbers. Wilson misses her first shot of her career. And we have a foul on Johnson blocking out. Good effort by Tariana Gary. Or actually, no, it goes the other way. Wait. Okay, no, the call's on Johnson. The crowd disagrees.
Oh, absolutely. The coach is wondering, where is that coming from? He's giving the ref a piece of his mind.
A little PG-13 vernacular there from Westmore. Good thing it's muted across the court. Nonetheless, Towson has the basketball, and Williams knocks in a 3.
Williams.
First 3-pointer for the Tigers. They start at 0-14.
Well, Williams is heating up. This is a second basket from the field on a nice jump shot.
Remember, Towson can score 85 points a game. A lot of work to do, but not over just yet. And Wilson called for the hand check.
You see Diamond on the handle. She has a superior ball handling skills.
You referenced Aaliyah Nelson as a Russell Westbrook type. How do you describe Diamond Johnson's game?
Diamond is just, she has a flair for the game. And she's a scorer.
Hobby, that's an easy layup.
That's sweet.
State nearly at a 50 burger here with 2 minutes to go in the half. Towson without Aaliyah Nelson the rest of this game with a knee injury. Top scorer averaging 25 a night. So Wilson lets it fly. Rivera,
there's
good
Rivera.
Offensive rebound.
Yeah, she's on the boards.
And the dump down pass is stolen. Look at Johnson hanging on to the basketball and give her 14.
Diamond Johnson on the push.
Johnson with a new career high, at least here at NC State.
I'm going to use all my diamond references. Diamonds are forever.
So Ernie, her career high arena. Is 26 at Rutgers. Could she get there tonight? Would she play enough minutes to reach 26 points?
Yeah, there's another half of basketball left. She can definitely do that.
Hobby wants to set up Johnson, who's excelled off the bench. Defensive challenge for Tarianna Gary. Now on the switch. Ooh, that's a mismatch for Hobby. A little fadeaway, that's pretty.
That's Hobby's game right there. She practices that all day in practice. So that's hard to guard down there. I love Hobby's game. She works hard in practice.
After a slow start the first two nights of this tournament, NC State's offense is clicking 66%. Rivera joins the party with her second three.
And she says, finally, I got one to go down.
Rivera can score in bunches. She does have 7 points, but it feels like she's taken plenty of good looks. Have a foul defensively on Towson here in the lane.
A little hand checking.
So the true freshman Wilson called for it. What a nice start for Diane Richardson's club. Really shocked the world in college basketball, upsetting Florida in a wire-to-wire victory. And this is a team that was picked third in the Colonial entering the year behind Delaware and James Madison. A lot of potential for this team once the healthy Rain Tucker and Aaliyah Nelson return.
Yeah, they're a good mid-major ball club, but they're playing here against the number five team in the country at home.
Shot clock down to 11, and Hobby, her rare miss of the night, just her first.
Hobby can make that shot.
Towson can hold for the final shot. I don't think they will. And Kubek is blocked. Good offensive board, Gary, to Napoleon, who hits it.
Napoleon just getting in the game.
For Jamie Napoleon, 17 starts last year for Central Connecticut State. Gets her first basket of the tournament. Bryant, late in the clock, swings it around to Timmons.
That's her shot.
And air balls a three to end the first half. About the only miss for the Wolfpack through the first 20 minutes. 63% shooting, and that goal right there. Diamond Johnson takes control, 14 points. Really doing it all for the Wolfpack in the first 20.
She's been in her bag this half, and she's not playing. She's getting back on track.
This home crowd for NC State likes what they've seen offensively. And we'll go down to Marilyn Payne in just a moment to talk with maybe the happiest man in the building, Wes Morris. His offense is cooking. Instead, we go down with Diane Richardson. Marilyn?
Overcome a tough shooting first half here.
Yeah, we haven't shot the ball very well, but we've got to keep shooting. And we know that we're a good shooting team. I think we just got to shake the nerves off and just keep shooting.
How will you be able to get your team to shake those nerves off?
Well, we've just got to understand that we deserve to be here. And so they've got to play. It's an invitational. We deserve to be here. So this is our chance.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Evan, back to you.
Thank you, Marilyn. Thank you, Coach Richardson. All NC State in the first half, a 30-point lead at the break. We'll have highlights and stats and plenty more when we return from Reynolds Coliseum.
College basketball is back, and many have dreams of raising the championship trophy in Minneapolis. But there are an elite few.
Yeah, with the halftime score of 50-20, Wolfpack leading, here's Rebecca Lobo with teams to watch in women's college basketball.
College basketball is back, and many have dreams of raising the championship trophy in Minneapolis. But there are an elite few, teams who won their conference championships a season ago and who return at least four starters who will grab your attention early. South Carolina's season ended with a heartbreaking loss in the Final Four.
Aaliyah Boston just misses at the buzzer!
But they return everyone, including All-American Aaliyah Boston. As UConn looks to continue its string of 13 straight Final Fours, it helps to have Paige Beckers.
Beckers a three, you bet!
And the number one recruit in the country, AZ Thud, joining a senior class who has never lost a game in the month of March. The reigning national champions, Stanford, look to defend their crown behind emerging star, Haley Jones. The new kids on the block, NC State, are on the ascent. Will this be their year? Or will Maryland, the highest scoring team in the country, run and gun their way to a national championship? I, for one, can't wait to watch.
Well, here's some of the big stories women's college basketball this year. How about Texas taking down the reigning national champions, Stanford out in Palo Alto, forcing 20 turnovers. Tara Vandiver is not going to be a happy camper about that.
No, she isn't.
And then, Ernie, the big game of the week. This past week, South Carolina comes into Raleigh, defeats number 5 NC State. Those teams kept their same rankings in the latest AP poll, so 1-5 here in week two. And then ranked teams just dominating in the first week of the season.
Yeah, it's a lot of great teams playing early in the season this year in women's college basketball. It's going to be an exciting year.
Let's look around the ACC conference because, of course, that's where NC State is based, and there are some teams that are really looking to make a run this year. Louisville with a tough loss to Arizona in overtime. That's an Arizona club that made it to the national championship game. And then here this weekend, Westmore, 750th victory. That's at a bunch of different programs, of course, including Chattanooga.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
But he's built himself quite a coaching resume.
Hey, he's one of the best coaches in the business. His teams love him. You know, he's hard on them. You know, he's not an easy guy to please. but he gets it done, and they respect him.
So, of course, the AP poll just came out today, week two, and that's where the shuffling slowly starts. You look at this top 25 ranking of Atlantic Coast Conference teams. Boy, Shipley and what Virginia Tech can do offensively at 25th, Georgia Tech, always solid. Florida State, a rising program under Sue Semeraut. And then Louisville, the big guns in this conference with NC State, that lost to Arizona, but still a very talented team.
Oh, absolutely. They always have a great team down there in Louisville. And the Wolfpack, being as though they played the number one team in the country, I didn't think they were going to fall too far in the national poll.
Arizona, in fact, one spot behind them at 11, and they just played last week. When we come back, some highlights from the first half. You see the numbers, plenty of points for NC State. We'll break it all down here from Reynolds Coliseum.
Record this. He's just out here basically.
Okay. The team that started. Yeah, okay. Okay.
NC State rolling with a 30-point lead, their largest scoring first half of the season, Ernie. And really, offensively, it was a balanced scoring day from the start.
Yes, inside out, outside in. Here we go with the Wolfpack. Camille, Hobby with the jump hook. Diamond with the nice pass. Hobby's just drop-stepping. They can't She's hard to guard down there. Here she is with the fallaway jumper.
She had 2 of 24 bench points for NC State today.
Yeah, and here's Diamond. She's not the Tigers' best friend right now. She's just raining jumpers, drives to the basket. Assortment of shots. Here she is on a push. She will not be denied.
Diamond Johnson taking over with 14 points. And here's some key numbers from that first half, Ernie. Field goal percentage for Towson, abysmal early start of 1 of 19 from the field. And then the injury to Leah Nelson late in the first quarter. Really a tough, detrimental injury to Towson. And then NC State took over.
Yeah, and I think that injury to Nelson has, you know, hurt their team confidence moving forward. When you lose a great player, 23 points a game, it's hard to come back from that, recover from that.
Now, Diane Richardson told Maryland at halftime, her team has to feel like they deserve to be here. How do you change that mindset as a player?
Well, I think they deserve to be here. They just coming up against a juggernaut, the number 5 team in the country at home. I mean, this will be a tough challenge for any team in the country, more or less the Towson Tigers.
Especially without the presence of all-conference forward Rain Tucker, who's sitting right there out with an ACL injury. She returns next week, and I can't even imagine what's going through Rain's mind watching the score and seeing her team being so close.
Well, she's coming back next week. I'm sure she's sitting there wishing she can play in this game right now. She's a competitor. She would love to be playing against the number 5 team in the country.
So Allie Kubek looks to fill those shoes. Not a lot of scoring, no points tonight for Allie. And certainly in this first half for Towson, needing some offense. Rivera had 7. Meanwhile, for the Wolfpack, 2 in double figures and 5 players with at least 6 points. And we'll have more with Maryland down with Wes Moore.
Coach, you said it coming into this weekend. You wanted your team to be more aggressive and you wanted to see a sense of urgency. Where have we seen that show up so far?
Yeah, I'm excited about our energy and the way we're, you know, on defense. We're trying to force issues and try to get out and run and transition. So I love our energy right now.
14 points in transition on the break. Who specifically has driven that force for you so far?
Well, you know, I think Diamond Johnson really makes things go, you know, and she kind of ignites it. But we want everybody involved, and you know, it takes everybody to run the floor to make it happen.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you, Maryland, because clearly, as Wes says, this offense thrives in transition. How has Diamond Johnson taken over this game?
She's just been everywhere, stealing the ball, rebounding, and she's pushing it. And that's what Coach works on in practice, pushing the ball up court and getting the right shot. You know, not the contested shot.
Wes Moore wasted no time getting back to that huddle after the interview. Earned his 750th win yesterday, and his team.
Coach is in shape.
Don't you think the next 20 minutes are going to be lackadaisical for NC State?
Oh, no. Every possession, all of these players are playing for time for the next game.
Second all-time meeting. NC State rolling here in the second ever matchup. It's been 7 years since these teams met. Wolfpack won 69-46. Here in Raleigh, back at the J. And Sky Williams comes up strong on the 3. 2 of 18 shooting from deep for Towson in the first half.
Towson is just not getting any fast break points.
And they've had clean looks from 3-point Rand. Meanwhile, Kunane just eating up space in the post. Intercepted by Kubek.
That was a good look by Kunane. It's hard to handle pass.
Well, it's a 30-point game. Can the Tigers get some confidence, cut this to 20, 15, make it interesting in the second half? Remember, they've averaged 85 points a game, has Towson, in the first 2 games of this tournament. But Noah Leah Nelson the rest of this game battling a knee injury.
See, the Wolfpack has got them in the half-court set. They don't score a lot of points in the half-court set. They score a lot of points on the break and fast break points.
That's an offensive foul. Ja'Kia Brown-Turner takes the charge. Complimenting her 7 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 blocks. That's a lot of stat-figging numbers.
Here's the charge right here by Turner.
And she just waiting for her feet outside the restricted arc. Might be the best skill of them all.
Yeah, right.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner rocking number 13 on the back of her sneakers. And playing like lucky 13 tonight. Big presence in the starting lineup.
See how the Wolfpack is being patient on offense, trying to find the right shot.
Here's a shot with four. An offensive rebound, Hayes, blocked by Rivera. Kunane is stripped, fouled. And Anissa Rivera adding up into foul trouble with three.
Madison Hayes.
Here's Aaliyah Nelson, who injured her knee, went down awkwardly late in the first quarter. And Ernie, with her presence, if she can come back, what a huge boost for Towson.
Yeah, she's on the bench right now. I don't think she's coming back in the game.
All she did Friday was set a building record, 39 points in the win over Florida. First Power 5 win in over a decade for Towson. That was a convincing wire-to-wire victory.
Yeah, they definitely kept the Gators at bay.
Florida got a win earlier today over Wofford, so 1-2 in the tournament for the SEC foe. This is a battle for first place, if you will, if this pod of the tournament. Kansas State hosts the opposite pod in Manhattan, Kansas. That's a long two, and Evans comes up strong. Look at Kunane running the
break.
Point. Up to Blatchfield.
Hayes. Look at Madison Hayes on the offensive rebound. She's just...
the energizer for Mississippi State.
Yes. She works hard on the offensive glass.
That's her fifth rebound in only 7 minutes.
She brings a lot of energy to the game. Here's Kunane on the break, looking like magic. Miss lay-in by Crutchfield, and the foul. Madison Hayes at the line.
Worth noting, Towson as a team, as you see Aaliyah Nelson about to check in, they're 10th in the country in rebounding. This team is so good on the boards. Today, however, they're minus 10 in rebounding and have really struggled to grab the basketball.
Yeah, they're playing against, again, one of the top rebounding teams in the country for the past 3 years. So they had a challenge.
Another offensive board for NC State. That's seven of them. Perez kicks to Crutchfield, wanting to find Kunane. She's double-teamed, so Hayes is open. And another offensive board. Perez's turn, and she knocks it in.
Reyna Perez letting it fly.
Rivera does her best.
They're not going to get in the game with shots like that.
And State comes out with the rebound. The Wolfpack now 15 above in rebounds.
Good pass.
Kunane puts it home. That was a great
Reyna
pass.
Perez set that up for Kunane with a nice lay-in.
11 assists on 21 baskets for NC State. They enter this game 10th in the country in assists per contest. Everyone's chasing UConn as the best passing team in the country. Rivera needs no pass, throws an over-the-shoulder shot, and a loose ball comes out to Hayes.
Elise Kunane came and contested that. She had no way to the basket.
Look at that mismatch for Kunane. Brown Turner needs no size advantage. There's a three.
You can't leave Brown Turner that open in transition. Again, the smoothest left-hand jumper in women's college basketball right there.
Diane Richardson wants a timeout as NC State starts the second half on 11-0 run. It's rain and threes for Reyna Perez.
Here's Reyna Perez knocking it down. There's Diamond.
NC State rolling here in the third quarter.
They do it in front of the band because it's loud.
Yeah, you can't hear
it. Yeah, you can't hear them.
Oh, there aren't a lot of options, unfortunately.
You got me?
Yeah, you want me on camera or no? I can.
Bench has scored more.
Sounds good, thank you. Invitational tournament, and you're here for a reason. She prides herself on being able to lead young women because of the coaches who she had teaching her growing up, causing her to leave a strong business career. Evan, you and Ernie know more about what she's done there.
Someone who left the business world to go into coaching because the love for student athletes, it was something that drove her every single night. She couldn't go to bed without thinking of what these athletes mean building up from her career as a player.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's paying off now.
Yeah, it's paying off now. I mean, the love of her players. She's a teacher. She wants to show them what's up. You know, she wants to show them what's, you know, how to move forward in life. You know, it means a lot to her.
That's the sixth NC State player to hit a three tonight. Reyna Perez gets on the board.
Nelson is back in the game.
Yeah, she just checked in before the last media timeout. Injured her knee in the first quarter. And you knew Aaliyah Nelson, who scored 39 on Friday in this building, would love to continue to battle it out for the Towson Tigers. Third-ranked team in the Colonial entering the season. With some potential. Dumping it downstairs. And a foul drawn on the drive. It's Fulmore attacking the basket.
Yeah, Hobby using a little hand action to keep her in front of her with the foul.
When NC State makes five or more three-pointers, they were 16-2 last year. And Ernie, the three-point arsenal has picked up again, seven threes tonight.
Yeah, Diamond has about, what, three or four of those. And Perez is knocking them down.
Nelson's turning for three, and you knew she would get involved. Aaliyah Nelson, the star of this tournament.
And she's limping. She's feeling it. But she got that shot up.
First field goal for Nelson, battling through a knee injury and foul trouble as well. That's something you want to see for Towson, the best player for the Tigers coming in and making a nice shot. All right, Wilson checks back in. Okay, Ernie, if you're Towson, clearly down 41, not going to come back in this game. What do you play for over the next 15 minutes?
You just want to run your stuff. You want to run your offense. You know, you're down 40, but you want to.
Well, down 43 now on another three-pointer.
Reyna Perez, again, she's a pro.
Look at Nelson attack the basket. Second chance, and it's in.
She has a lot of heart, and that's what she's playing with right now.
This is what made this matchup so scintillating early, the matchup of Nelson versus Kinane. And with Nelson back in the lineup, this game becomes a lot more interesting in the fourth quarter.
Yes. I mean, if she's...
Oh, here she goes.
They're not getting back into this game.
Nelson one on two, pops a jumper. Okay. 7 points back from injury.
Yeah, quick 7 points.
And that knee is still giving Aaliyah trouble.
But she's fighting through it.
The Bean, the nickname from Diane Richardson. She's playing like a woman on a mission.
She's a gamer. They're going to need a lot more of that from her to get back into this one.
Diamond Johnson's been putting on the display moves all day. Ooh. And just rattled out of three.
Coach didn't like that shot, though.
4 of 7 from deep in the second half. Nelson, the country's 10th leading scorer, kicks it outside. Now wants a deep three. Ooh. Kubek trying to save it, and it goes to Hayes.
Oh.
Off the head of Hobby. The lob. The low, no, lay-in no good. Oh, that's a tough miss for Kubek. You can tell NC State's size is getting in the head of Towson tonight. Hobby, meanwhile,
that's
no
trouble. They're making it simple for Camille. Here she is on the defensive end.
And Hobby with the steal.
Hobby's pushing it.
So a double dribble turns it over.
Coach doesn't like to see that.
We'll take the
timeout.
Get
it to the point guard.
Welcome back to the ballgame, Aaliyah Nelson. 9 points in the blink of an eye for Towson.
Here she goes. Here she is on the runner. Nice pull up right here. Jumper by Nelson.
NC State living on the three-point ball, plus five from deep with Ja'Kia Brown-Turner and Reyna Perez really heating up this offense.
Yeah, Reyna Perez has caught three-point fever in the second half.
In fact, in this third quarter, NC State 4 of 7 from three-point range. A club that last year led the ACC in three-point shooting. Now it's a three for Wilson. That's way off. Offensive rebound, Towson. Dodson floats it in.
Yeah, nice offensive rebound by Dodson.
Nari Dodson
strong with that.
Gets Towson to 29 points. The starters for Towson have now outscored NC State's bench 29-27. However, the starters for the Wolfpack have taken over this game, especially in the first half. Largest lead of 44.
Ooh.
Look at Johnson. That's Ooh. Pretty.
That was sweet.
10 shy of her career high, set back last year at Rutgers, 26. We asked her early, could she get to 26? Definitely a possibility.
She keeps hitting the three-pointer like that. She's going to get 10 points real quick.
Williams looks to the clock at 10. Chucks up with three herself. And the Towson three-point woes have continued, 3 of 25. Meanwhile, Diamond Johnson, no trouble from deep.
Here she goes on the crossover. Bang!
What a token Diamond Johnson has become, the transfer from Rutgers in year one. Had 10 points yesterday, and now with 16 in this game, taking an elite step tonight.
Yeah, she's a scorer. I mean, she's a great player. I mean, she's not just some sub coming off the bench. She averaged 17 points a game in the Big Ten. So she can play.
NC State has shot better than 45% in 12 of the last 15 quarters. They continue that hot shooting tonight. As an offensive rebound for James. And a jump ball. Evans and James tangle up. Possession stays here.
James is really athletic. She has bounce for a young freshman.
Zaya James from Virginia Beach, Virginia, to Princess Anne High School. 13 points in this tournament so far. A lot of second half minutes and two blowout victories, including a 33-point win over Florida yesterday.
This is what I expected from NC State. All in this game.
All it took was a slow first half against Wofford on Friday, only leading by 5. And the Wolfpack have dominated since. There's a traveling on Diamond Johnson.
Diamond has a little happy feet. I don't see the traveling, but the head and shoulder fake that gets the refs. I'm telling you.
You were a guard at NC State. You love to take that extra half step.
Oh, yeah.
Two and a half. Good hesitation by Williams drawing the foul. It's an arm bar before the shot.
Yeah, they used to get Jordan back in the day on that quick first step. Coach Dean Smith used to argue about that all the time with the refs. Like, he was so quick that, you know, he wasn't really taking three steps. You just, you know. She has a quick first step. And I think the refs ain't used to seeing that.
Refs have had no trouble watching these teams go to work tonight. 10 combined three-pointers, and Williams can't get the bounce.
There's Diamond with the rebound and the push.
Watch Diamond Johnson.
Head up.
Kick out to Brown Turner.
Flash.
8 three-pointers for NC State.
You can't let her line it up because it's going down.
Shakir
Brown Turner.
Last season, 38% from three-point range. Off to a nice start this year at over 50%. It is just 4 games in, but a good sign. The Wolfpack are hitting their threes as Wilson clangs one off the backboard. Johnson, the distributor. There's your three-point shooter. And a rare miss for NC State with a foul on Wilson trying to box out Isaiah James.
Isaiah James is on the offensive boards. She's a good-looking young player. Coach is trying to get all his young players in, because when these guys leave, he says, this is the future.
He refers to
Isaiah James and Genesis Bryant.
Referring to the 3 seniors that elected to return for this final season. On a roster that kind of slots out more upperclassmen heavy. 8 upperclassmen. And Jakia Brown Turner gets a round of applause to the bench. Every Saturday, The Huddle with Jordan Cornett, Eric McLean, E.J. Manuel, and Mark Rick get you ready for ACC football. They'll preview the slate of games and keep you updated on all things ACC, 10 a.m. Eastern on ACC Network and the ESPN app. James misses both from the charity stripe. One of the rare areas the Wolfpack have missed shots. Towson, meanwhile, shooting it at just 20%, and Williams throws up a prayer. How valuable are these next 11 minutes for this young NC State lineup?
Very valuable, because they all playing for
as
playing
James
time.
Gets on the board for the first time.
There's the future right there, James. You got Timmons out there.
This freshman class, it's been a challenge for Westmore, balancing the senior heavy lineup and the freshman in reserves. But tonight, a chance to get extended minutes. And Gary takes an extra step for the travel.
Everybody's traveling in this game today.
That is a point of emphasis in women's college basketball
yes,
this year.
Yes,
referees
is.
Are really keeping an eye on traveling violations. The Towson Tigers looking to bounce back after a 3-0 start, a loss tonight for sure. They look to dethrone Drexel, the reigning tournament champions and the preseason favorites along with Delaware. Of course, Ella Della Don, so dominant in her days up north.
Yes.
WNBA player on this Towson club as well, Kiana Jeter, drafted by the Las
Good
Vegas
Aces
this year, and Hobby lays it in.
You see James take an extra bounce to get that wraparound pass to Camille Hobby for the lay-in.
That breaks a 9-0 NC State run, makes it 11 straight. And Nelson at the gun. That's a nice floater. Nelson in the double figures, playing through a knee injury. However, no answer for NC State.
No, that was a strong drive to the basket by Nelson.
28-point quarter for the Wolfpack, led by the three-point game. Five triples in the third.
Here's James on a nice lay-in. Ja'Kia Brown-Turner knocking it down.
A young and talented NC State team that returns 94% of its scoring. You'll see plenty of freshmen and transfers the rest of the way, Ernie, featuring a top 12 recruiting class.
Oh, man, they are loaded. And the only problem they're going to have is finding time for all these players. That's going to be coach's challenge moving forward.
You see Sophie Hart checking in as well, the freshman center. How does Westmore evaluate these next 10 minutes in terms of getting minutes for his players down the road?
Well, I mean, this quarter is going to be like kind of garbage time, but he still wants the game played correctly. Coach Moore style basketball.
First look at Genesis Bryant, who finds the shooter in Timmons. Good rebound Hayes and a block Rivera. Bryant's turn, and she knocks down the jumper, joining the scoring party. That's 11 players to score tonight.
Genesis Bryant is a good ball player coming off the bench. She's one of the top high school players in the country. Coming out in her class.
Six underclassmen for Westmore. You'll see plenty of them in this fourth quarter as Kubek off on the three. Oh, six shooting for the all-CAA member last year. Nice pass from Hayes. And Bryant can't make it pay off. Big rebound, Anissa Rivera. Towson loves to run. This is their strength in transition. 26 transition points per game. Such a dangerous team when they get on the run. And Quebec gets on the board.
Yeah, Quebec. Nice jump hook in the lane.
Ernie, what has NC State done to limit the transition ability of the Towson Tigers?
They've just been getting back on defense, you know, stopping them on the fast break, just getting back and establishing position.
That 33 points for Towson.
Making them play the half-court game.
A season low, averaging 85 a game entering this one. Hayes, good slip down to Hart. Late in the clock.
Hart!
Her first points.
Nice jump hook by Hart. Good pass in the lane. That's her first basket.
10 of the 12 players entering tonight for Westmore have scored. Dominant end of the WNIT is Quebec with the foul. That's a great spin move.
Yeah, that was a nice drop step spin move.
Little lean, little work of the window.
Oh, yeah. She's kind of schooling hard right now in the post play.
Alec Quebec, the first freshman to start every regular season game last year since 2006. She completes the three-point play. NC State with the loss last Tuesday to South Carolina. They have dominated the last three opponents if you count tonight. What a response from West Moore's club as James knocks in the corner three.
James is a good-looking freshman.
Also helps when you hit 9 three-pointers in a contest.
Yeah.
Nelson gets into double figures and then some. He had her 13.
She has a great go-to-the-hole game.
And Ernie, this is what we hope to have seen from Aaliyah Nelson. Got injured at the final minute of the first quarter. Her game is fantastic when she's healthy.
When she's healthy, yes, she is. She's a great offensive ball player.
Jen Bryant blocked by Quebec. Nice steal. Nelson tips
Nelson
it away.
Playing some good defense.
Towson can run. Last year, top 10 in the country in scoring. Struggled to end the year in terms of record at 13-9, but a very offensive-minded club. Rivera goes to her left. That's her offhand, and it floats in.
Now, they're playing well against the reserves, against the freshmen out here. And sophomores.
Nonetheless, though, Wes Moore's going to watch this tape.
Oh, yeah. Without question. He's going to find. That's not her shot.
Hayes with an air ball on the three. Barely touched anything. Outlet. Rivera intercepted. Stays here.
She shot that air ball, but she got back on defense and disrupted that play.
Otherwise, a
Madison
layup.
Hayes plays hard, but that three-point shot is not her game.
That's exactly what Wes Moore is explaining to her. 3 minutes into this final quarter, Rivera gets an extra step. Offensive rebound, Quebec, and there's 7 points in the quarter.
Yeah, Quebec.
Quebec, the All-CAA freshman team member last year. Timmons attacks. Wanting to join the scoring party. She'd be the 11th Wolfpack player to score. Nelson's had no trouble scoring herself.
There's Rivera.
Not a bad look either. Just could not hit. Rebound Gary. Nelson, deep three.
It's a tough shot. Even for Nelson.
Diane Richardson will deal with. She loves the scoring ability.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Somehow finds Hart, who kicks
out.
It to Timmons. Back down to Hayes. NC State dishing and diming the ball all over the court.
Yeah, great passing and the way they're looking for their players. Check out this save from James with a nice dish, keeping her head up. Good-looking freshman.
Isaiah James set her career high in her debut, 9 points against Wofford, part of that top 15 recruiting class. And Westmore mentioning that this team will become more of hers and many others who are young, especially next year.
Madison Hayes is not a great free throw shooter.
We'll have a college basketball quadruple header for you Friday with women's games at 2 and 4. And Towson at Pitt at 6, but we're featuring the finale with Coach K at number 9 Duke hosting Lafayette and Cameron Indoor. Freshman phenom Paolo Banchero has lived up to the hype so far for the Blue Devils. You can watch the game on ACC Network and the ESPN app. Good game on Saturday, by the way. Duke and Campbell, a couple of Carolina squads. That was a single-digit game until the final minute.
Yeah.
Coach K, 1,100 career victories in that one. Meanwhile, Wes Moore earned win number 750 yesterday. We'll have 751 in about 5 minutes. Gary splits the double,
defense.
Gets to the rack, and banks it in.
She's very athletic. Nice drive to the basket for Gary.
Terriana Gary, 12-point-a-game scorer. Tonight, however, just her first bucket. It's been the story for a lot of Towson shooting. 39% in this half, but really struggling in the first. Nelson playing through a knee injury, hanging tough in the second half. But can't stop
Genesis.
Jen Bryant.
Nice scoop. Layup to the basket. Genesis Bryant on a nice drive by.
10 different players have scored for Towson, or for NC State, I should say.
There's Madison Hayes. That's her game, the hustle game.
12th turnover forced by the Wolfpack. Leads to free throws for Madison Hayes. And we've seen NC State run in transition in this fourth quarter. When we come back, the final 4.5 minutes. Please stick with this. Plenty of new freshmen introduced you to for NC State as they lead, doubling up the Towson Tigers.
Officials.
The Towson Tigers waiting for a big key cog to return. The JMU transfer, Rain Tucker, two-time All-Conference. She's expected to be back from an ACL injury next Tuesday. And what a dynamic piece for Towson.
Yeah, she's going to be a great addition when she gets back next week. Great player, very athletic. I know she's looking at this game wishing she can be in there right now and helping her team.
Diane Richardson mentioning with Tucker out, kind of has that Kawhi Leonard type ability for her team, can do many different things on the court. You combine that with Nelson and then Rivera, it's a dangerous team in the CAA.
Yeah, absolutely. They're going to be a tough out in that conference.
However, NC State's had no trouble with Towson tonight. Diane Richardson in year five, leading a squad off to their best start in 5 years as they'll head back home to take on Millersville and Howard next week. NC State stays home as well, facing Kansas State in the finale of the women's NIT this Friday. That before heading to the Bahamas, which I need to get on that flight if I can.
You and me both.
I don't know how much pull I have with Wes Moore these days, nonetheless. Good kick out by Nelson, and Napoleon comes up short.
Jen Bryan on the push.
NC State last scored 100 points November 29th of last season in a win over NC Central. They'd love to clip that mark here tonight. Have a chance with 4 minutes to play. James wants to help the cause. Rebound Hart and 91.
Hart! Showing a lot of heart out here.
How about the reaction from Kunane that time, cheering on her freshman son?
Oh, yeah. She has to guard Kunane in practice every day, and that's a tough challenge.
Kunane.
She's learning. She's learning a lot. From
double-double yesterday in limited minutes. But Kunane, nonetheless, effective 15-4 for the All-American candidate.
And that's the Wolfpack. That's how they are in practice. They cheer one another on, and that's what makes a great team. Nobody on this team is jealous. You know, they really enjoy each other. I've been to a lot of practices.
And you still can't get a trip to the Bahamas out of it. Here's a long two.
And I don't know, man. I might be able to. I might be able to get that done.
Sophie Hart getting position in the post.
Oh, good pass.
And finishing it off.
Sophie Hart.
11 NC State players have scored tonight. This is a 7-0 run.
Sophie saying, hey, I want that spot when Kunane leaves.
That's the big question. Three seniors, Kunane eligible for the draft as well. Could return if she wants. And out of the free throw line goes Quinzaya Fulmore.
Here's Sophie on the post up with the sweet pass to Timmons. I think all of NC State players have scored.
All but one. Kayla Jones has not scored tonight. Ironically, she was the breakout scorer against Wofford, 15 points on Friday.
I think coach is saving her legs for the next game. She's a starter. She's a star.
There's Kayla Jones enjoying the scene as her teammates have combined for 93 points.
I tell you this, last year, if Kayla Jones didn't get hurt, they would have made it to the Final Four. Some WNBA team is going to be lucky to have her.
Load management.
In the organization.
Always important, especially early in the season with a near 50-point lead. Wilson off the pick. And the true freshman rains it down in their debut. 7 points for the freshman. Hart lobs it in. A bit strong. Westmore pointing to his head. He likes the idea.
Yeah, he likes the idea. It's a good look. And she got obviously passed because we just saw him throw a nice dish.
13 turnovers first NC State tonight. Is that worrisome at all if you're Westmore?
Not in a game like this.
Nelson around the screen. Great step back dribble and pops the J.
Aaliyah.
Nelson playing through injury, giving her squad 15 points.
Tough shot.
James with a great floater.
Coach didn't like that shot. It went down. It's one of those, she knocked it down.
The race to 100 is on here with 2 minutes to play.
Coach is trying to teach James to take the shot that is given to you.
Towson draws a foul on the drive in. That's Hobby committing the harm. And now the fifth foul for NC State. Or fourth foul, I should say. Hobby's had some nice minutes tonight.
Yeah.
Double figures for the second time in her career.
Hobby, it can start for a lot of teams in the ACC.
The bench has dominated. 50 bench points for NC State. Keep in mind, 48 total points for Towson.
See, the defensive intensity stays the same.
Leaves Nelson open for three, and she cannot hit. Look at Nelson sprinting for the rebound and runs out of space as Towson now 3 of 31 from downtown. That's a hard number regardless of who you play.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree.
Remember, Towson entered this game making 9 threes a contest. Hit 10 threes against Florida on Friday. One of the hottest scoring teams in the country, but no answer for NC State.
NC State is one of the top defensive teams in the country. And this is their home court. I know Towson has played some tough teams.
James! Nearly a beautiful finish.
Coach doesn't like that move, James.
And Nelson.
James likes to go. She likes to go one-on-one. And that's not Coach Moore's style of basketball.
Westmore always coaching even into the final minute of this fourth quarter.
I mean, she's talented, and she's going to make a lot of those shots. But Coach likes it in the flow of the offense.
11 of 12 players have scored tonight for NC State, searching for 100 in home game number 4 for the Wolfpack. Williams lost it. James puts it home. 97.
I think they're gonna hit the 100 mark in this game. 48 seconds left.
In a game where the Wolfpack have shot at 56%.
It depends on this possession, how much time runs off the clock.
That's a quick shot for Williams and a nice finish. Towson up to 50. Williams has 7 herself. Let's see what Westmore decides. He's gonna hold the horses here and dribble out the clock. The bench wants it. Can they get to 97 to 100? Here's your chance. Timmons for 3. 100!
Timmons with the corner jumper to hit the century mark.
From 0 to 100 in 59 minutes and 50 seconds.
See, I told you I thought they were going to hit that. I thought they were going to hit it.
Nelson on
these,
the drive.
These freshmen can score.
NC State, a dominant 40 minutes of basketball tonight, hitting their 10th three of the game.
Great shooting display by the Wolfpack.
You sort of knew a three-pointer was coming there, and Timmons knocked it in.
Yeah, she's one of the top scorers, well, the top scorer in women's basketball, high school basketball, in the state of North Carolina. Scored over 2,000 points.
Triple digits, not very common. It's been since November 29th of 2019. The Wolfpack have reached 100. They do so on a perfect 100.
They're not going to shoot this, Coach says. Just dribble it out.
NC State stormed out to a 21-point first quarter lead and take control here in the first weekend of the preseason WNIT. 3 straight wins for Wolfpack West's club as the Wolfpack dominate 11 on the scoreboard in a convincing win over Towson.
Yeah, I think we're going to interview Diamond Johnson.
What a performance by Diamond today, Ernie. Not only the scoring, but the assist making. Kunane was
the rebounds. She just was all over the place.
16 points for Johnson, her new NC State high. How did she take control of this game in that first half?
Man, she just played her game. She was in her groove. She was in her bag. And she just took over and led the Wolfpack to a 48-point win in Reynolds Coliseum.
Johnson scored 16 of 55 bench points.
Are we gonna
for NC State tonight?
There she is, Diamond, shining bright.
Taking their pictures with the photographer, having a good old time. Ernie, this was a 3-0 weekend for NC State here in the WNIT.
Look at them.
What did they show you in this weekend's performance?
They showed me that Coach said he was going to fix some things after the South Carolina game. And I think he did fix some things because they scored the ball, they shared the ball. They look like the number 5 team in the country.
Westmore earns win 751. Not as glamorous as yesterday's victory, but impressive on the scoreboard. 48 points. And Ernie, let's talk about Diamond Johnson some more, the player of the game. Not only 16 points, but did it in so many different dynamic ways offensively.
Oh, man. Pull-up jump shots, 3-pointers, drives to the basket. I mean, she was just rolling today, shining bright like a diamond. Here she is on the lofty one-hander, the shake and bake, 3-pointer straight down the bank. Here she is with the nice crossover step back. I'm from Philly. Here she is on a nice drive.
One of 5 players in double figures, Diamond Johnson, taking over this basketball game. And she's on the court with Marilyn Payne. Marilyn with our player of the game.
At the entry, save 3 ticket to an
You led your team in scoring tonight, the best game for you here at NC State. How were you able to find your shot in so many different places on the floor in this one?
I've been watching film, and I've just been in the gym. I watch film on where I get my shot set, where my teammates going to set me up to get my shot set. So it's just been a lot of film these past few days. We had 3 games in 4 days, so it was just a lot of film.
What specifically did you see on film from Towson that set you up this way?
I saw that they switch a lot on the guards. They overplay a little bit. They big so high, so it's good for me to attack and, you know, kick and help my teammates. Long as we attacked and dish, we was good.
It wasn't just offensive for you. Rebounding the ball, grabbing those steals, and setting your teammates up with those assists. How do you feel you're coming into your own here with the Wolfpack?
I just try to do what I can for my teammates and for us to win. I think it's just not about scoring. It's about defensive rebound also. I just try to be more than one-dimensional.
Well, you certainly were that tonight. Congratulations. Thanks for your time, Diamond.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Maryland. Thank you, Diamond. NC State, a third straight victory. It was a rout from the start against the Towson Tigers. 100 points for Wolfpack West's club, knocking down threes from all over the court. 10 triples and some celebrations at the end. For my man Ernie, Evan Budjevich here, signing off from the Reynolds Coliseum. NC State, a top 5 team in the country, playing like it tonight. Plenty of scoring for the Wolfpack. This is a presentation of ESPN as NC State scores 100 points.
Good job.